Welcome, everybody.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to this public day event of the African German Entrepreneurship Academy, AGEA. Thank you for joining us from wherever you're joining us from Ghana, from Rwanda, from other parts of Africa and from Germany. You are most welcome. My name is Bismarck Ejeye Boa, and I'm part of the AGEA coordinating team here at the University of Leipzig. And I'll be moderating this event together with my colleague here.
Yeah, my name is Catherine Similian. I work also at the SEPT International, and yeah, I'm very happy to welcome all of you.
Yeah, once again, thank you and welcome. This is the part of the AGEA 2020 conference, and we ideally this event should have happened in person, but since the global pandemic and the limitations that it brings, we would have to manage this event digitally. And so we are glad that we are able to do this, and thank you, and I hope that you stay with us all throughout. Since it's digital, there are some technical information that we would like to share with you, and my colleague Catherine will do that.
So in order to facilitate this virtual public day event, please consider the following. The session will be recorded and shared on our channel. Those you will have the chance to watch it again in case you miss any part due to internet connection or other reasons. Don't hesitate to use the chat function so we can collect your questions and answer them during the event or later. In order to use this function, you need to be registered on YouTube. Leipzig University will facilitate the sessions. We are streaming live from the Center for Media and Communication, CMK. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Catherine. We would want to move on, and we want to acknowledge some of our project partners. This project, since 2007, has been supported by the Federal Ministry for Economic Cooperation and Development, and also the DAAD. It's been implemented under the auspices of the Small Enterprise Promotion and Training Program here at the University of Leipzig. And we have country partners in Ghana, the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, and INES Ruhengeri in Rwanda. We also have private sector partners who have been part of this project, and these in Germany have been coordinated by the SMILE initiative here in Leipzig, and also we had private sector partners in Ghana and also in Rwanda. My colleague Catherine will take us through the activities of the day, and we will continue from there. So
we will give you a short overview of the agenda for today. We will now follow with the opening speeches of the three heads of the program, then hear a guest speech from the National Chamber of Commerce and Industry in Ghana, followed by a message from our AGEA partner university in Rwanda. And then Bismarck will introduce you to the AGEA Idea competition. You will see the top five videos of Ghana projects in a video blog, followed by another block of videos of the top five ideas from Rwanda. Then Bismarck will give instructions for our public voting, and during a musical interlude, you will have time to vote on Menti. We will explain that later. And afterwards, you will have a chance to get your questions answered. We will be very excited to later first have our colleague Robert Meyer giving AGEA activities and next steps. And then we will finally announce the top three ideas out of the public voting. So yes, this is the short overview for today.
Thank you, Catherine. So we have an exciting time ahead of us, and I believe that you would be with us throughout. The information on the idea competition would come a bit later. But before then, we want to take the opening messages from our heads of the program. We would begin with Professor Dr. Utz Domberger, who really wanted to be here today to be part of this event, but due to some issues, he's not able to join us, but then he's sending us his message via video. And so let us take the message from Professor Utz Domberger.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon, students. I would like to give you a warm welcome to our public day of the African German Entrepreneurship Academy, with the focus on multiplying entrepreneurship promotion in Ghana and Rwanda. You know, for us in AGEA and the joint universities supporting the AGEA development in Ghana, when we talk about KNUST, and in Rwanda, when we talk about INES Ruhengeri, and in Germany, when we talk about Leipzig University, it's very important to foster the role of the university in promoting entrepreneurship. We are convinced that universities should play a very important role in promoting local economic development. And of course, one thing what we can do at university is to promote entrepreneurship among our students. That is the reason why in the last years, together with the support from the German Academic Exchange Service, we developed the African German Entrepreneurship Academy, in particular in Ghana and Rwanda. Today we have these two hubs inside AGEA, and more than 30 higher education universities joined AGEA in Ghana and Rwanda in order to promote entrepreneurship. Today it's also a big pleasure for me that we celebrate the award ceremony of our idea competition. Unfortunately, we cannot run this event face to face. Corona did not allow us to travel to Ghana to run the event there. So we have to do it online. But even when we do it online, I think we will see very interesting business ideas today. And I hope that the winners, and not only the winners, all business ideas which were developed in the last weeks by different groups of students, we can support them to bring them to the market. Today, I think, even in the Corona time, it's a good time to think about to create a business. We can see it here at Leipzig University that in the recent months, we had the same amount of startups and young students coming to us with new business ideas than we had in 2019. So I think we should promote the entrepreneurial spirit of our students. I hope that we will have a very fruitful day today. And very important thing, I would like to invite the winner of today to see if we can bring this startup project also to Germany, to support them here for some time, to get them incubated at Leipzig University for some weeks, in order to push the development of their startup. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Dr. Utz Domberger. And now please listen to our second opening speech by the second head of this program, Mr. Samuel Akumea from KNUST in Ghana.
Hello, my name is Samuel Akumea, a senior lecturer at the KNUST School of Business. I am the head of the Center for Business Development, an office under the Vice Chancellor's office, which seeks to engage students and researchers in entrepreneurship practice. I am also a country director for AGEA. AGEA stands for African German Entrepreneurship Academy. We have worked together with the partners since 2017. The partners in AGEA involve Leipzig University, which is the lead university from the north, and KNUST, as well as INES in Rwanda. So it's more or less a tripartite partnership. We have two strong legs for AGEA. The first one is the summer schools we organize for students who have interest in entrepreneurship. AGEA uses modern tools in entrepreneurship teaching. Every year, 30 students, 10 from each of the partner schools, gather in one of the partner universities, and we train them and get them to develop prototypes. So far, different types of prototypes have been developed, and we are looking for funding to upscale some of them. The other leg of AGEA is networking of entrepreneurship teachers in institutions of higher learning. Currently, Ghana has about 18 schools, and we have others still knocking at our doors trying to join. So we hope that we can get at least up to 20 schools to be part of the AGEA network. What we do with that network is to organize training for the lecturers who teach entrepreneurship in their various schools to establish entrepreneurship centers, or if they can, also establish business incubators. That will be beneficial to students who have interest in entrepreneurship practice. We see that a lot of schools do entrepreneurship teaching, but do not go further to see how the students who have the ideas can bring them to the market. That is exactly what the business incubators seek to do. And AGEA has been able to do that for these schools that have been part of the network. Currently, schools like UMass, University of Mines and Technology, they have approval from the school management to establish a business incubator. University of Development Studies from Tamale also has approval to establish another incubator in agribusiness. There's a university in Accra called Heritage Christian College. They have also established a business incubator. And others from the technical universities have also established entrepreneurship centers, like KTU, which is Kofuridi Technical University, Owo Technical University, and there are others that is also in the process. So we know that AGEA has been beneficial to institutions and to individuals. And currently we have a new project which is born out of AGEA, known as ACCESS. And ACCESS is a bigger project and is going to continue what we started by bringing on board research, industry, academia relationship, and also e-coaching. So in all, we think that from 2012, since we started the partnership with Leipzig University, we developed the partnership called In4In. In4In represents intelligence for innovation. That gave birth to AGEA, and AGEA has given birth to ACCESS. And at the end of the day, there's African universities, African students, African lecturers, and the African community that becomes the beneficiary of all these projects. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Akomiya, for the welcome and the insights that you have given us on the ACCESS and its activities in Ghana. We will move on from Ghana to Rwanda, and we will take the opening remark from Father Dr. Hagnimana Fabian, who is a Vice Chancellor of INES Ruhengeri in Rwanda.
Dear partners of AGEA Project and friends, I'm Father Dr. Hagenimana Fabian, the Vice Chancellor of INES Ruhengeri, University of Applied Sciences in Rwanda. We are very pleased to join this conference for expressing our joy and satisfaction for everything we have achieved through the African German Entrepreneurship Academy, AGEA. INES Ruhengeri is privileged to have hosted this project. As a hub in Rwanda, INES played a key role in spreading this opportunity to more than 10 higher learning institutions in Rwanda, coordinated national trainings and competitions of more than 151 students from these institutions. Out of such competitors, 30 students participated actively in summer schools in Germany, Ghana, and Rwanda. I commend these young, talented students who keep showing us that even though problems are there, they also have solutions to them. Thanks a lot to DRD financial support, the working environment from partner institutions and mentors for their invaluable service. There are many benefits from AGEA project that can be highlighted. Through institutional active membership to AGEA, students and staff develop their capacities in entrepreneurship, learning, and support schemes. They also learned from peers in Ghana, Germany, and Rwanda, which opened their mindset for international horizons. AGEA and partner institutions now have alumni and good ambassadors. Some are self-employed, others are good employees, while others are still exploring better opportunities. From this, we can attest that AGEA played a positive impact in linking students and staff to the private sector and the world of employment market. In line with this employment market, transition from traditional teaching and working conditions to modern digitalized mode of operation, there are plenty of uncertainties surrounding how best and fast ways employability skills required on the market can be identified, developed, and transferred to students. We are pleased that from the lessons learned from AGEA, it emerged the African Center for Career Enhancement and Skills Support Access Project, which will emphasize on developing and transferring students, graduates, employability skills between 2020 and 2024. We are hopeful that partner institutions as well as others will benefit a lot from its components: research, capacity building, university business linkage, and entrepreneurship promotion. The interest and motivation of various institutions to be part of this new journey is a sign of a long-lasting active collaboration between partners in Africa and counterparts in Germany. This is a credit to Professor Dr. Utz Domberger from Leipzig University and his team, hoping to continue cementing our partnership via joint activities. I wish all participants the best of their plans. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. So now, dear audience, please listen to the guest speech of Mr. Stephen Achiampong, the chairman of the Ashanti region of the National Chamber of Commerce and Industries in Ghana.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Stephen Achiampong, regional chairman for Ghana National Chamber of Commerce and Industry, lecturer and HOD of Ghana Baptist University College, director of Jabinwura Bank, director of Global Model Community School, and author of Achi series. I am very glad to be part of African German Entrepreneurship Education Academy. A keynote on contributions of practice-oriented entrepreneurship education for socio-economic development of African nations. The level of societal development very much depends on the quality and innovative capabilities of the people. According to Walter Rodney, African alone is endowed with about 28% of the total world resources. However, it is the poorest. Japan is not endowed with economic resources, but it is an advanced country. Professor Bene of University of Ghana made it clear that resources are not, they become. Development is a change brought by man to improve upon the standard of living of the socioeconomic well-being of a people. By default, man has dominion over all creation and can think, create, invent, innovate, and add value to all natural resources. The major difference between developed and underdeveloped countries, poor and the rich, is in fact the differences in technology and innovative capabilities, as well as hands-on education. Poverty, unemployment, low productivity, and underemployment are all psychologically, culturally, and environmentally determined and are characteristics of underdevelopment. Can-do-it attitude, determination, honesty, and hard work, integrity, patriotism, and nationalism are the foundation of development. Most African countries after independence have tagged entrepreneurship as a risky venture. Classical definition for entrepreneurship, you look at that. Entrepreneurship is seen as taking the risk to organize resources such as land, labor, capital to produce goods and services. In fact, the emphasis on risk makes most people to pursue courses that will train them to become job seekers rather than job creators. The formal educational system has done very little to develop entrepreneurship in African countries. Modern definitions, Scott Shein, he said, entrepreneurship is an activity that involves the discovery, evaluation, and exploitation of opportunities to introduce new goods and services, ways of organizing market processes, and new materials through organizing efforts that previously had not existed. In the same vein, Howard Stevenson from Harvard University also said, entrepreneurship is the pursuit of opportunity without regard for resources currently controlled. Comparing the classical and modern views, most people want to pursue opportunities rather than taking risk. Entrepreneurship is about looking for problems and finding solutions to them. People who find solutions to problems are able to become great entrepreneurs. Bill Gates, Mark Zuckerberg, and so on do not depend on natural resources, but rather innovate capabilities to create businesses. Study successful entrepreneurs, their history, their principles, their sources of funds, and their achievement, so that you can apply it to your life and become successful entrepreneurs. This is the type of education we need. Ladies and gentlemen, we now talk about practice-oriented entrepreneurship education. Education is a process that begins in the mind and manifests in the actions of men. Society has not been static, but dynamic, that keeps on changing, as the existing social institutions changes, especially the educational institution is an agent for these changes. Education is the most powerful tool for holistic transformation in all aspects of life, including economic, social, cultural, and political. Practice-oriented entrepreneurship education that started in Western Europe was accompanied by agricultural mechanization and increased productivity, which consequently led to agricultural, industrial, and digital revolutions. However, entrepreneurship education in Africa has been basically theoretical and limited to higher education, thereby creating a gap between theory and practice. After independence, most African countries started training graduates in humanities to become employees of state-owned enterprises. The collapse of state-owned enterprises has created unemployment with the attendant social vices. Practice-oriented entrepreneurship education is seen as the best solution for sustainable development in Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, how can practice-oriented education be achieved in Africa? One, we need to focus more on case studies. By studying past and present corporate success stories and successful entrepreneurs, including Bill Gates, Dell, Dangote, Kwame Nkrumah, Henry Ford, the study of most successful business gurus reveal common characteristics that run through all of them. Most of them combine education with work. Therefore, entrepreneurship needs to be integrated into educational curriculum to promote hands-on entrepreneurship. They also started with ideas and concepts to promote hands-on education. And that was their capital. In Deuteronomy 8:18, it says, God has given you the ability to create wealth. He didn't give you money. So your ability is your most important capital and your creative power. Most of them use personal savings for initial funding. They started from a very humble beginning and expanded. They believe in honesty, hard work, and passion. And then also they focus on long term. They have principles and philosophies. They believe in corporate social responsibility. Two, entrepreneurship needs to be integrated into the educational curriculum at all levels, starting from preschool, as is being done in India and China, in order to promote entrepreneurship in Africa. Three, technology, innovation, and creativity need to be promoted through mentorship programs and technology fairs. Four, the need to create opportunities for students to participate in social entrepreneurship contests. Five, developing proper succession plan to be able to hand over businesses to generations. Six, the need to partner with businesses. Thus, prominent universities already have partnership agreements with businesses through internship programs. Seven, business executives to deliver lectures to students to mentor them. Eight, help students launch their own businesses, help them to conduct research and have access to funding so that all business decisions will be based on empirical evidence. Nine, foster entrepreneurship exchange programs with other institutions, with as we in the case of Erasmus in Europe. And then 10, to encourage entrepreneurship in students, universities must offer more practical coursework and then blending the theory and practice. 11, to encourage students to join global and recognize entrepreneurship associations such as the Chamber of Commerce for exposure, capacity building, negotiation skills, and networking. 12, practice-oriented entrepreneurship education will help create sustainable business systems in Africa to minimize business failure. Ladies and gentlemen, we will finally focus on benefits of practice-oriented entrepreneurship education. One, practice-oriented education will bring innovations, creativity, and inventions. With innovations, Africans can harness their natural resources and transform them to value-added products. 3, Africa will increase the raw materials for industrialization from best agricultural and mining practices. 4, many jobs will be created and unemployment and social vices will no more be a problem. GDP and per capita incomes will increase and standard of living will be enhanced. Thus, poverty profile will be reduced. Then 6, much wealth will be created and Africa will enjoy more goods and services to improve upon the standard of living. Africa will emerge as a developed economy. Practice-oriented entrepreneurship education will promote capital formation in Africa and in the world as a whole. And then 10, it will promote balanced regional development. Entrepreneurs help to remove regional disparities through setting up of industries in less developed and backward areas. It will reduce concentration of economic power in the few, in the hands of a few. Practice-oriented entrepreneurship education will sharpen the negotiation skills of Africans to become competitive in global economy. Political stability will be promoted as many people become self-reliant. Corporate tax revenues will be increased in developing economies, and government can provide social services and infrastructure facilities to promote sustainable development. Ladies and gentlemen, to recap, hands-on entrepreneurship education in Africa is the road to transformation of developing economies. With AGEA, it is hoped that the entrepreneurship gaps will be bridged through mentorship and appropriate technology transfer, as well as management skills and best practices to ensure sustainability of businesses among all the partner countries. The mutual benefit is that transformation of African economies through entrepreneurship will reduce dependency syndrome, global social vices arising from unemployment, poverty, and terrorism. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. God bless you.
Thanks to Mr. Achiampong, we could listen to one of our business partners, and now we will listen to one of our academic partners. Listen to the message from AGEA Partner University Rwanda, Mr. Engineer Emil Abayisenga. And we want to encourage you to make use of the chat function in our YouTube channel to give us your comments and to ask your questions. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Abayisenga Emil, the principal of IPRC Musanze, one of the AGEA project beneficiaries universities in Rwanda. Let me give you a little background of IPRC Musanze structure and how AGEA project was an added value to our agenda. We are a young institution that was established in 2015 with 5 programs: agriculture and food processing, irrigation and drainage technology, civil engineering, electrical engineering, and hospitality management. We train to produce entrepreneurs and not job seekers. That's why we have dedicated members of staff in charge of career guidance support, entrepreneurship support, and business incubation support. Since 2017, these dedicated members of staff have gained a lot through AGEA project by gaining trainings and workshops, and the knowledge gained was transferred to all our students and colleagues. Not only staff members gained, but also a number of students gained directly through trainings, coaching, mentorings, workshops, and summer schools here in Rwanda, but also in Ghana and in Germany. This has helped them to mature and fine-tune their businesses' ideas, and now are selling. Actually, I was told that one of them is soon going to sign a joint venture contract with his counterpart in Germany as a result of 2017 German Summer School. Let me conclude by thanking all of you who directly or indirectly contributed to this initiative, and my special thanks goes to Leipzig University, the initiator of this project, and INES Ruhengeri for inviting IPRC Musanze to join this noble cause. I pledge IPRC Musanze participation and the collaboration in future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you to all the our leaders who have given us their introduction and welcome speeches. We are gradually moving to the highlight of today's event, which is the idea competition. We also want to still encourage you to share your thoughts and your questions in the chat function on the YouTube channel. Send us your questions, and please also include where you are sending us the where you are joining us from, so that we can know where you are. Now we are moving to the idea competition, and I would want to take briefly to introduce you to the process that we have gone through to this point. So the process started in July thereabout, and in August, we started the online application platform where we requested for information or ideas from students and AGEA alumni from Ghana and also Rwanda. That was the first stage. We got in total 48 teams, with some individuals applying and sending in their application in the first application round. In the second application round, this was 33 applications that we got, and this moved on to the second stage of the competition, which is the jury evaluation and selection of the top 10. At this point, I want to thank the jury in Rwanda and in Ghana who participated in screening the ideas and shortlisting to the top 10. The next stage was the development of a promotional video, and this is what we are going to use in today's event to help us decide the top three ideas. And to decide this top three ideas, we would need you, the public or the audience joining us today, to vote and later on. But for now, we would share with you the ideas. But before we share with you the ideas, we want to let you know that as you go through the ideas, pay attention and already start making your mind as to which you are going to select as your top idea or your best idea for which country, so that when it gets to the voting session, you'll be able to easily do it. So we'll present to you the top 10 ideas out of the competition so far. Here are they.
So we will have five competitors from Ghana. You will learn more about Agriota, JobWall, CoronaSet, WellFed, and SmartLearn.
From Rwanda, we have manufacturing of small-sized agricultural machines and tools, AgriBuy platform, G-Robot, manufacture of telephone accessories from recycled plastics, and biofortification of Irish potatoes. So with that, we want to move on straight to see the videos and the details of the ideas. We want to start with the first five from Ghana, and we start with Agriota.
Hello, my name is Conlan, a student of KNUST, the university in Ghana.
I am Lois Elinam Atadika.
And I am Harriet Sewa Kumujan.
In sub-Saharan Africa, farmers face low crop yields due to under and over irrigation. According to Grow Africa, farmers in sub-Saharan Africa harvest 20 to 30 bushels of corn grain per acre. This is equal to the amount of crops or the amount of harvest a farmer in North America was making in the 1940s. This is even worse in the three northern parts of Ghana, where farmers have only one dry season, thereby leaving farmers in abject poverty. AGEA is an IoT farming system that gives farmers environmentally driven data. With the environmentally driven data, AGEA waters crops automatically at the right time and conditions. It detects crop stress and all, which makes farming more cost effective, more productive, and great for the environment. So I'm going to show you our initial prototype. With this, we are able to take the environmentally driven data, like the water content, the pH level of the soil, the temperature and humidity of the soil, the wind directions, and other environmentally driven data that is good for the farmer. And with this, our system inside this mini PC is able to process it and give predictive farming, things that are best for the farmer. When the farmers will water the crops, which the system does that automatically, when the farmer will be accessing harvest, and other data that the farmer needs to make a great harvest. We are looking to impact farmers' economy greatly by giving them the system, which increases crop yields by 40%, reduces water used on the farm by 33%. With our system, we bring automation and efficiency to the African farmer. You can see the difference between these crops. You can see that these crops are doing very well with the information we've provided to the farmer. With our information, the farmer is able to apply the right fertilizer, the right amount of water. And you can see that these crops are doing very, really well. And looking at our control experiment, this is the natural system the farmer uses. So you can see that these crops are not doing as much as these crops are doing, although we planted them at the same time. At AGEA, we improve local farmers' yields and to meet international standards.
Thanks to AGEA, it was really impressive to see the different crops. And now please pay attention to the idea of job wall.
Hello everyone, my name is Michael Osejia Wo. Job Wall is an innovative web app solution which provides virtual internships and job opportunities for individuals anywhere, everywhere, across the globe. Our platform operates on a B2B business model, which provides a virtual working space for organizations to give tasks, track records, and hold meetings.
Before the pre-COVID normalcy, major businesses obeyed the 8-to-5 work rule. But the shock that came along with the pandemic affected a number of Ghanaian businesses. Businesses had to let go of over 42,000 employees, according to a report by the World Bank. Also, they had to cut short work hours and move working locations from the office to the home. Business transactions, school activities, job opportunities, and even internships were all put on hold. Despite the size, scope, and intensity of the pandemic, major businesses stabilized quickly. But there were changes that have altered the way we think and go about work. This is the future of work, and it has shown that there's a need to invest in a better virtual workforce.
The platform employs an efficient payment system that includes electronic wallet transaction between users and organizations.
Freelancers can also benefit from our platform by providing essential services for our businesses, services such as web development, graphic design, and even data analytics.
Our target market is students in higher education institutions, corporate organizations, and academic professionals.
The future of work looks at corporate flexibility, where individuals, corporate organizations, and academic professionals can access tasks and share them remotely. Job World will be partnering with corporate organizations, academic institutions, and business entities to upload tasks, virtual internships, and job opportunities for individuals to access. On a daily basis, companies have the opportunity to post a task. The criteria for selection of the best task is based on efficiency, speed, and creativity.
The impact of Job World is targeted at increasing employability of users by providing avenues to build professional goals. We are providing low-income earners and the unemployed with a stable source of income, advancing economic growth in relation to SDG 8. In the future, Job World will include hands-on tutoring services to enable users acquire skills for the job market.
Job World,
your partner for job opportunities. Thank you.
Very interesting idea from Job World, and we wish them the best. We would move on to the next one, which is Corona Set Smart Bin.
Hi. I'm Dapa Michael, Koforidua Technical University, Ghana. You all saw what we demonstrated. When I had to dispose of the bottle, I had to lift the lid of the bin with my hand. So was the case with my colleague, Benjamin. And these are the sort of bins used in public places in Ghana. Who knows how many people are touching these bins and what's left behind?
In this era of COVID-19, my colleague and I have come up with a solution to reduce the spread of the virus.
We present to you the Smart Bin.
With our bins, we employ smart technology such as motion sensor detection, automation, and digital data for waste management. Through the use of solar energy, we are able to power our sensors for the bins for deployment in public areas. This makes it safe to dump rubbish anywhere without the fear of contracting COVID-19 or any other diseases. When the bins get full, the system sends an alert to the waste management organization to ensure waste is collected promptly. This will also help city managers to monitor the work of waste companies operating in various areas in the country.
We believe with the adoption of our smart bins, we stand a chance of preventing the spread of the virus and other diseases. Thank you.
Thank you very much for this smart bin idea. And now, please pay attention to well-fed.
Hi, I'm Christiana Opombrinya.
I'm Oseiti Tuagbi Samson.
And I'm Jijo Amasunwata.
We are Team Well-Fed, a group of innovative students seeking to solve the problem of post-harvest losses in Ghana.
According to the Food and Agriculture Organization, a third of all food produced globally is lost, accounting for $1 trillion. In Ghana, 35% of food goes waste, and this contributes to the release of methane gas every year, causing global warming. Akumadan is a community in Ghana with a population of over 7,000 farmers. It was once the nation's supplier of fresh tomatoes, but due to lack of preservation units, the produce of the farmers decay in a short time after harvest. Upon conducting a market research and interacting with the farmers to reduce post-harvest losses, we established Project Well-Fed. Well-Fed is an agricultural project that empowers farmers through education on appropriate farming methods, provides an effective means for tomato preservation, and connects farmers to buyers. We are partnered with Farmerline to provide education using 8 intensive in-person training models, and we have also designed a zero-emission cooling chamber used to keep tomatoes fresh for 15 to 20 days until it has ready market. Our model has prudent features as compared to the traditional preservation methods and competitors. It preserves tomatoes 4 times as effective when compared to the 5-day period used by farmers, reduces environmental footprints by controlling methane and carbon dioxide emissions, and it is cost effective. Well-Fed is providing tomato farmers and the unemployed with a stable source of income as it brings farmers to modern farming techniques and connects them directly to buyers. Our target market includes smallholder farmers and traders across Ghana. In the next 2 years, WellFed will scale up to 2 communities, lifting close to 15,000 smallholder farmers in Ghana above the poverty line. Our storage chambers have the capacity of 50-25 kg crates. Every crate stored with us goes for 50 pesos a day, with an estimated 700 cedis a month, and we will generate up to 8,400 cedis in a year for each chamber we construct. The WellFed technology massively impacts not only farmers and traders, but consumers of agricultural produce. Our project ensures that the decay of farm produce, especially tomatoes, is drastically reduced. Thus, agricultural produce gets to the consumer wholesome enough for consumption. This improves healthy lifestyle and an effective manpower in terms of human resource in the country. Farmers get good returns to support themselves and families as well. Some SDGs our project tackles are no poverty, zero hunger, good health and well-being, and climate action.
Having heard our project story, we hope to gain your support and votes to make our project a success. Thank you so much.
Thank you, team from WellFed. Wonderful. Thank you for sharing your ideas with us. We'll move on to the next one and the final one from the Ghana set, which is Smart Learn.
Hello, my name is Moses Osabute.
And I am Joseph Apia Nketiah.
And we are from Ghana Communication Technology University. And the title of our project is
Smart Learn.
COVID-19 has brought with it various challenges to individuals and educational institutions, resulting in the closure of schools, thereby forcing a lot of students to stay at home and study. Many people find it very difficult and boring to study all alone and at home.
Based on statistics from UNESCO in Africa, about 1/3 of children between the ages of 6 and 12 and also 1/5 of children between the ages of 12 and 14 are out of school.
One major relevance of Smart Learn is to enhance and to train the memory. It also provides a fun way of learning and also helps to control stress.
The innovation of this project is to incorporate African fun games through learning.
So in terms of feasibility, we are looking at picking the educational curriculum as well as using technological tools to be able to create the given aspect of the project. So the aspect of the project includes English, mathematics and general knowledge and history. So in terms of English, we are looking at punctuation, grammatical errors, summary, phonetics, as well as paragraphing. And when we come to the mathematical aspects, we are looking at using mathematics to be able to solve problems. And general knowledge, we are looking at basic knowledge to be able to assess and equip the person to be able to improve their knowledge and concepts. So with Smart Learn, learn smart, be smart, think smart, have fun. Thank you very much for watching. Smart Learn for you.
Thank you, Smart Learn, for sharing your ideas with us. So we have finished with the first 5 videos. We will continue with the second batch of videos from Rwanda. But before we do that, we will want to take a short break. Before we go on the break, we would want to still encourage you to be interactive in the comment session. Send in your comments, your thoughts, and your questions, and we would address the questions that we can hear later on, and those that we can would find a way to get back to you on that. In the break, we are taking a short musical break, and we want to have a musical video from Rwanda, which gives us a very nice perspective of the country, Rwanda. Though we can't travel there now because of Corona, we'll be able to see Rwanda through the eyes of this video. So let's take a short break and we'll come back with the videos from Rwanda. Thank you.
Now
yanje igiye nikingo nkuvuga imyato gusingiza umudatuzi
nda general ndirimbe mamije bishireke
shayagirire nikunde mu mubyimbo gukumbuza bataguheruka maze abagusura mbasurutse batangara
umwambaro w'ubunyarwanda nambaye mukesha wongo byame ubu ndakenye ndite umucyo ni wose ndarabakira
imigo ndayikomeje rwanda rwanjye nzasigasira ibyiza byawe maze isi yose ikuhanga amaso begerana rwanda rwanjye rabagirana rwanda nkunda uri ikirezi mu bawe
Thank you so much for this beautiful musical interlude. And now we will have the Rwanda Ideas 5 videos. And we will start with the manufacturing of small-size agricultural machines and tools.
Hello everyone, I'm called Islaye Nyonshuti from Rwanda. 70% of total Rwandan population is employed in agriculture. This industry contributes 31% to GDP. In Rwanda, farmers are in different categories. More farmers are found in middle class category. These farmers in the middle class face different challenges due to the traditional farming method they use. It's time-consuming, non-standard, raise produce, and at the end is promote labor hardship. Developed countries use tractors and machines to save time, improve standard, and improve their productivities. Due to the standards of middle-class farmers, they can't afford to adopt these advanced agricultural mechanizations. As a child of farmer, I understand this, and I know the farmers' hardships. This is why a group of engineering students came up with an idea of making small-sized, affordable agriculture tools and machines. The first prototypes were made to test the market, and from the collected feedback, we are planning to launch our first final products in the beginning of 2021. We are open for any kind of support from private sector and government institutions. We believe in the power of the unit. Our aim is to educate and change the life of a farmer. We are calling everyone to join us in the lead of changing the community, especially for those ones in middle-class farmers. We believe in the future, and we hope the future is bright. Thank you.
Thank you very much for sharing this idea with us. We want to move on to another wonderful idea from the AgriBuy platform.
Hello everyone, my name is Ngenzi Shakaja. I'm a student of INES Ruhengeri in Computer Science Department. And my business idea is AgriBuy.rw platform. This is a combination of e-commerce and ICT into agriculture. So many farmers around the country produce a lot of food crops. They face the challenge of having less market for their production. So this is not only because the people and the clients don't need the food crops, but it is because they have no medium to link them to the farmers. So I decided to create a platform that acts as a link between farmers and their clients. This will help farmers sell their food crops anytime from anywhere. It will not only help the farmers but also their clients to conduct a market research through the platform to find out about the products they need and the information so that they can buy easily from where they are. So I decided to target the people who need food crops in a large amount. Those are hotels, restaurants, boarding schools, supermarkets, and also wholesalers. Through this platform, 366 tons per year will be conducted, and according to my calculations, the cost structure will be 13 million, and the estimation of the income will be 27 million. So the profit will be 14 million as an estimation, and this is through the platform where each product sold through it will have a profit of 20% per kilo. The impact of this business idea to the society is that there will be application of digital technology into agriculture, there will be an economic growth and market rising, there will also be the connection between farmers and their clients around the whole country to be a contribution to smart agriculture, which is one of the main goals in our country. Thank you.
Thank you very much for this platform idea. And now we will have G. Robert.
Thank you. I'm Guy Nishimu, I'm Rwandan, and my project is G. Robot. G. Robot is a CAD robot, and it is 4-in-1 robot which deal with lifting, carrying, transporting, excavating the land, detecting harmful gases, and provide irrigation, which is smart irrigation. With this G-Robot, there are some constraints that nowadays we face in society. For example, lack of a diversified machine, a machine which can perform many activities at the same time, human voluntary constraint like accident related to death, and machine which pollute the air or provide environmental degradation because of use of fuel, petrol derivative, expensive machines which read too expensive or cost of working. This robot is 4-in-1 robot. It is a solution I want to solve in society. It is very cheap according to the normal existing machines. Also, it provides different sizes according to the affordability and working conditions, like small size, which can lift up to 5 kilograms, medium size, up to 5 tons, and big size, which can lift up to 15 tons. Also, due to technology we used in this robot, it uses three different technology: manual system, which use hands-on control, mechanical system, buttons on control, and Android system, which use your mobile phone or your personal computer just to control it. And also, another solution, it provides smart irrigation in different sectors like agriculture, and it also detects harmful gases, reading to death, or to prevent those human-oriented constraints. My target market are farmers, agriculture in the general sector, mining sector, mining industries, private or individual, also industry, construction companies, and industries which deal with heavy things. Those are my main target market. The model of profit for G-Robot is through selling the robot, renting the robot, also providing a training. However, we need technical support for further development of this robot, shifting from working prototype to the final product. The impact on the society of G-Robot, the first thing is to protect the environment, because to use water and solar energy instead of fuel or petrol derivative. Also, it provide and promote the protection of humans, and to prevent human-related constraints like accident that lead to death. Also, every citizen or every people can just buy this robot because it's very cheap according to the normal size. And also, it's very adequate for everyone to use because the technology it contains is very, very easy. So, thank you.
Thank you very much, G-Robot, for sharing your ideas. We are getting close and closer to the point, the decision-making point. We have two more videos to see, and then we can make our decisions. The next one is manufacture of telephone accessories from recycled plastics.
S'aggrave et que leur impact puisse être irréversible. C'est de là qu'est venue l'idée de mettre en place une start-up spécialisée dans le recyclage des déchets plastiques pour fabriquer les pièces et les accessoires électroniques. L'objectif étant de minimiser l'impact environnemental dû aux déchets plastiques et contribuer à la lutte contre la pauvreté. Comment ça va se passer? Nous allons produire dans un premier temps des coques de téléphone et des couvercles des ordinateurs obtenus à partir des sacs et bouteilles en plastique que nous retrouvons un peu partout. Groupe cible de 2500 clients. Après étude et analyse du marché, ce projet a un impact significatif sur l'environnement et contribue aussi à la lutte contre la pauvreté. Et il constitue en lui-même une véritable opportunité d'affaires pour nous tous. J'ai dit et je vous remercie.
Thank you very much for this presentation, and now please pay attention to the last one. It is the biofortification of Irish potatoes.
Thank you. I'm Kwame Nkrumah from INES Ruhengeri, student in level 4 food biotechnology. The project name is biofortification of Irish potato, and it is all about production of fortified Irish potato that contain iron and zinc to provide comparative cost-effective and sustainable means of delivering more micronutrients. After deep analysis of the situation of my country, where we have 70% of Rwandan population rely on agriculture, which is the main area of economic sector, and the health study population suffer from food insecurity and malnutrition. Our product, which is by fortification of Irish potato, will address the main problem of malnutrition, and in general it will help to handle the problem of food insecurity. The target market is farmers, food seed producers and householders. Our project will require the startup cost 42 million Rwandan franc, and the money will be recovered in 3 years. The project, it will improve the health status of Rwandan people and to provide job opportunity. Thank you for being attentive.
Thank you for the information. And so we have come to the end of the videos, and now we are going to the decision-making time. I would want to take short time to introduce you to the voting platform and how you would be able to help us decide the top three ideas in this competition. So you go to the website www.menti.com. Now, for those voting for the Ghana ideas, you go to, in there, you put the code 3255292. 3255392. That is for the Ghana idea. If you want to vote for an idea from Rwanda, you go to, in there, in the code section, you put in the code 3780837. You can decide which one you want to vote for, the Ghana idea or the Rwandan idea, which one of them. When you go to, when you put in the code, you would have access to the ideas, and then you select one. Select one, and each person is supposed to vote once. So you help us to make this decision, and then we select the top three ideas. Now, during this time, the voting platform would be open now, and so you can start voting now. We would take a musical break from the Unity Drummers in Cape Coast, and as the musical break is going on, we would be going along with the voting as well. So please take note, the information of the voting will still be on the on display for you, and you can always refer to it and then make your votes. But we have about 8 minutes to do this voting, so please do your votes, select your best idea, and then we can put it together to make the final decision. And don't forget to send your comments and your thoughts.
Hey!
Wow, that was a wonderful performance, and I hope you have voted, because very soon the voting platform will be closed in a few minutes. And I'm very happy to have been joined by my colleague, Robert Meyer, who is the coordinator of AGEA, also here from the University of Leipzig. And he's going to help us address a few questions and comments, and then he will tell us some of the next steps for AGEA in the coming days, weeks, years, probably. Yeah, so we would want to take the questions. So far we have two main questions, and I'll just read them out, and then you can, as much as possible, we can see how best we can respond to them. So the first one says, embedding theory in practicals is a challenge we notice in our universities. How can it be solved, especially among lecturers and students?
Well, first of all, thank you very much for allowing me to join you. And thanks to all of you who are watching. It is really impressive to see how many people are watching this stream. And of course, I think a lot of you are watching because of these kind of questions. They are pressing, and especially this question about how to link theory and practice in our, well, complicated world is... Yeah. Indeed a challenge.
Yeah.
And we need to be aware that it's a challenge we won't solve ourselves. We have to solve it jointly. Mm-hmm. And I think therefore it's good to have this community of people who deal with this, people who are engaged in universities, in lecturing, but also the students who bring their ideas. As we have seen today, there are so brilliant ideas around in the heads of students. So we have to bring these kind of things together, and we have to try new concepts. And I think the universities are a great ecosystem to try new ideas and to approach new ways of thinking. And we have to go one step further from there. We have to link universities with the world of work, with real businesses, but with all other kinds of organizations as well, in order to make these kind of ideas work. And I think this is partly an answer to this question. Of course, yeah. The type of teaching, what we are addressing in the Access project that was previously named, is also part of the answer to this question.
Yeah, I think, of course, it's for this reason that the AGEA project actually is existing. So we are trying and helping as much as possible to contribute to this. And because of our time, we'll move on to the next question, which is related to COVID. It says that COVID is bound to challenge the entrepreneurial space. How can entrepreneurship, and specifically AGEA, rise to this challenge? This is quite specific.
We just received a copy of the questions here.
Yeah.
Well, I think what this whole COVID crisis is showing to us is it's a game changer. We can't travel anymore. We have difficulties to meet in our offices, so we have to find new ways. And I think exactly this is what also challenges businesses now, to come up with new solutions to new problems or old problems that have not been as pressing as they are at the moment. So I think this is the answer that I have at the moment.
Okay, thank you very much. There are some questions that are directed to the projects, and we might not be able to respond to this, but I'll just read them out quickly, and then we'll move on to the next step. So there's a question on the smart bin, and says that, how do you secure the smart bins from theft at public places? That is a very valid question, and we need to think about that. We would also forward these questions to the people who can give us the answers, and then we would share these answers later on our website or other platforms that we would use. The other one is, what about the affordability of the technologies to small farmers? I presume this might be relating to the idea from Rwanda in terms of developing small equipment for agriculture. We would also pass this on. So I think in all, we have had some good feedback from those who are watching us. And thank you very much for your comments. We will move on to the next steps for AGEA. Very soon, we are going to announce the top three. Very soon, we are going to announce the top three. And but then we will take the next steps, few steps for AGEA, the AGEA project from my colleague, Robert Meyer.
Yes. Well, let me try to introduce to you a little bit what is ahead of us. Of course, we have to make the knowledge that we created now available. Throughout this project, we have created different tools, different methods. We have developed the content of different summer schools, and all this is knowledge that is an asset to other universities as well. So we'll document this and we'll make it available in printing as well as digitally, basically as we are doing at the moment as well. We are broadcasting what we are doing, and we should continue this way of communicating these kind of things. And then of course we'll use also our InfoIn website, where we are gathering knowledge for innovation or for innovative networks, to broadcast this information. And then, of course, there is a network that has evolved out of this project. We can actually see this from the comments in this live stream, because a lot of the participants who are commenting there are previous participants of summer schools, are lecturers who have been involved in trainings. So these are networks that we have to operationalize and that we have to further work with. And one way to work with this network is now to integrate the AGEA network into the Access network. As I mentioned before, we have this other project. It is mainly dealing with employability of graduates, and entrepreneurship promotion is basically a part in this set of tools to work on the employability of graduates. So we'll use this, and we'll integrate this network into the network of this new big project called Access, and we'll carry the knowledge that we created in AGEA into this other project. And then of course we have to develop new projects together with the existing partners, but also together with new partners, in order to apply this knowledge. And then there's one step that goes beyond this. Of course, we have these ideas. We also have to work with these ideas, and we have to try to link these ideas with people who can further advance the ideas. I mentioned before that universities are a great ecosystem to develop ideas and to come up with new solutions, but universities are not a perfect environment to implement the ideas. At some point, the idea has to graduate into the real world, the world of business. And this is a step that we also have to launch together with our partners from the businesses. Yeah, so these are the steps that I would like to tell you about that are ahead of us.
Thank you very much, Robert, for sharing these next steps and the insights on the what is ahead of us in terms of AGEA and Access and the whole entrepreneurship, practice-oriented entrepreneurship promotion within Africa, in collaboration with the University of Leipzig and other universities. So we are almost at the end of our event, but we cannot go without revealing the top three. I'm so excited about showing the top three ideas. And thank you all for voting. You have voted massively, and we appreciate that and your participation in this event. We want to quickly go to the next step, and then we would see. So are you ready for the next? So we are going to reveal them one by one. So the first in the top three is WellFed. Congratulations to WellFed. You ended up in the top three ideas. Thank you for your idea. And congratulations to you and the team in WellFed. So we want to see the next one. The next one is Smart Learn, also from Ghana. Smart Learn. So congratulations to the team with Smart Learn in that for your idea, and it's in the top three. Finally, the last one in the top three is small-sized agricultural machines and tools. That's from you, Rwanda. Congratulations. So, ladies and gentlemen, these are the top three ideas of our AGEA Idea Competition 2020. And I want to say congratulations to those in the top three, and as well all those who ended up in the top 10. The ideas were brilliant, very innovative, and we thank you for sharing them with us. Unfortunately, we can have top three, and we congratulate the top three, and also you for being in the top 10. We believe that going on, we'll be able to still work on these ideas and help to improve them. So I think that we have gradually come to the end of our event today. We want to thank all those who have supported us, the partners and the sponsors who have provided funds for us. We would also want to thank our coordinators in Ghana and in Rwanda, who have been working tirelessly over the past weeks and months to make sure that all the tools and the things that we needed for this event to be successful, we got them, especially Mr. Isaac Dodu in Ghana and also Mr. Gonzalez in Rwanda. Thank you very much for your efforts. We also have our website, the AGEAacademy.da, and we encourage you to visit our website and get more information about the project and the activities that we are doing. Also, you can also contact us directly. The email from Robert and myself are available, and you can contact us directly, and we would respond to your queries or your issue that you raise. So thank you very much for being part of this event, and hopefully we would keep in touch and have a good evening or have a good night wherever you are joining us from. Thank you.